the lucky luck of the Irish, yes. I guess, right?
we get like you said.
Any type of thunderstorms, hit and miss, so maybe your neighborhood will get some, but we have several days of that, so that's the best part.
All right, Ted. Hey, busy Thursday night in sports.
Ron is in for Chris tonight, and we'll start up with some pretty good news for the Little Leaguers.
This is fun, okay? It's always fun when you can talk about the Little Leaguers, okay? A group of 12-year-olds from Summerlin, one state, they're now hoping to make some noise against the best in the West down in Southern California. And what does it take to be the best in the Nets? Put your mask on for a special 11 o'clock version of our Knights Icebreakers next in sports. Well, hi, everybody. Don't let the 105 degrees fool you. This is football weather right here, right now, okay? And for the first time here in Las Vegas, we can talk NFL training camps and really mean it, okay? The Raiders are fired up for 2017. They won 12 games last year and have a lot of reasons to be optimistic going into tomorrow's training camp. Got 90 players reporting, along with our own Chris Matthews. He's taping his ankles, getting ready to give us reports throughout training camp beginning tomorrow. Yeah, the rookies' pre-camp warm-up is over, so now it's the real deal. Here's the schedule for you over the next few days. The vets report tomorrow. First practice is Saturday. Then on the 31st, they will practice with pads for real for the first time. Then a reminder, coming up on September 2nd, 7:30 right here on Channel 8, our special 30-minute West Coast training camp show. Then every week throughout the season, a 30-minute weekly Raider special titled Silver and Black Attack. Well, it'll debut September 9th, 7:30, right here on CBS, your network home for the AFC and the Raiders. I'm not real good at math, but I think there are more Raiders games on 8 News Now than any other station in town. Somebody double-check my math on that one. I'm pretty sure about this one. That, yeah, more right here on 8 News Now. Okay, everybody in town remembers the excitement when Mountain Ridge Little League gave it to Las Vegas when they went to the World Series 3 years ago. This year, Summerlin South is hoping they get to make that same trip, but first things first, they're headed to San Bernardino next week to begin play against other teams in the West. First game is Sunday, August 6th, against the Southern California champs. The game will be televised on ESPN3. Here's the team working out tonight at Mesa's Park in the southwest part of the valley. Beautiful weather out there tonight. This team is deep. They got guys who can crush the ball, a great lineup of pitchers, and a lot of optimism heading into the Western Regionals.
I think we all are brothers out here. We all play for each other for the name on the front.
So they're all playing for each other. And they love each other. Great bunch of kids who really, really, really enjoy being with each other and having a good time. And they're just hungry to win. They want to do good. They want to have fun.
Okay, well, the team is raising money for their trip. A website has been set up to help raise the $10,000 they need to spend the week in San Bernardino. They're about a quarter of the way there. You can go to our website, lasvegasnow.com, and you will find the link where you can go to help out. Okay, breaking news here. The Washington Nationals can crush the ball, okay? You had the Yankees a few years back. They had their murderer's row. Now the Nationals have Harper, Murphy, and Zimmerman. Together, they are hard to shut down. Well, today, Michael Blazek of the Brewers was the victim. Washington tied a franchise record with 8 home runs. The third inning was the toughest for the Brewers and Blazek. Nats tied a major league record with 5 home runs, all of them off Blazek in that same third inning. That's abusive. Harper again. There he goes in the third. Nats added 6 more runs in the fourth inning. Harper hit 2 home runs today to run his total of 27 on the season. He also ran his hitting streak to 19 games as the Nats rout the Brewers 15-2. There goes another one. Okay. Perhaps no position in all of sports has evolved as rapidly as the goalkeeper, the goaltender or the goalie, whatever you want to call him. Now, to play that position, you've got to be tough and have the right equipment.
This group, the best 4 defensemen in the playoffs, and a team that wearing those jerseys.
Any hockey expert will tell you, the game begins and ends with the goalkeeper. If you've got a great one, you'll win. If you don't, you won't. But the goalie has got to come prepared. It's called your trapper.
Yeah, here's your blocker.
And that's your blocker.
Yeah.
Okay.
Goes on just like any other mitt. Your goalie stick.
Bigger. Well, the goalie stick is different.
That's right. Bigger is better.
Bigger is better. But you can't have just piles of big gear to stop the puck. There are those rules.
You'll see the NHL is doing a crackdown now on the size of gear.
Okay.
And you'll find most goalies are actually pretty good athletes these days. So, like your boys like Jonathan Quick, and Carey Price. These guys, as the equipment got smaller, they got better.
Then there's the all-important mask.
Just made of Kevlar. It's a standard issue. Cat's eye cages. This is what most of the pros use now.
Cat's eye cages?
Yep, just for better vision.
Right. And as the equipment has evolved, so has the game.
Used to be just to stop the first shot in the 80s, and you were done. Your job was done. Good goalies will be able to control the rebounds and 90% of the time put them where they want to.
Average number of goals right now in the NHL, 5.5 per game for both teams. Now, it used to be in the early 90s about 7 goals per game. So the goalkeeping, defenders, that part of the game is getting better progressively, as we see.
Looking forward to the season.
And by the way, yes, the Knights have a great goalkeeper in Marc-Andre Fleury.
Yes.
So that's a good place.
So we got that going for
a new franchise.
One name I remember. Yes. Thanks, Ron.
That's right.
Still ahead tonight, a mysterious bug bite baffles doctors and a not-so-pleasant trip to Target. Our strange stories are back after this.